Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today I will give you a short tutorial on actinomycosis. So that is our today's learning topic of discussion. This belongs to the infection category. Alright, so which are the learning objective for today's topic of discussion? So objective is to understand the definition of actinomycosis. Then we will see the types of actinomycosis, and finally we will see the morphology, diagnosis and the treatment portion of actinomycosis. Alright, so let's begin with the introduction. What is actinomycosis? So this particular infection, this bacterial infection, is caused by an organism known by the name Actinomycete israelii. That is the causative organism. It's an anaerobic bacteria, and this infection is very rare. It's not a common infection. So we can say that, guys, Actinomycosis is an anaerobic chronic bacterial suppurative infection. So that is the definition of actinomycosis infection. You have to remember, guys, that it's a bacterial infection, not a fungal infection, which is a common misconception. Alright. Now this particular organism, Actinomycete, is normally present in our different regions. In the three region, it is a normal commensal. So that areas are oral cavity, then your gastrointestinal tract, then your vagina. So in these three region, it can be normal commensal, means it is normally present. All right so you might have questioned that when actinomycosis occurs. So whenever this bacteria, this small amount of bacteria, is getting proliferated, when they will proliferate, particularly especially if your immunity is low, so because of bacterial proliferation, you will develop an abscess, and that is actinomycosis infection, which can be hazardous for your health. So it's an endogenous infection. It is due to proliferation of normal commensals of your body, and it doesn't spread by physical contact. Alright. Now, types of actinomycosis. Which are the different types? So there are basically a four type of actinomycosis infection, and these four types are given according to the site of involvement. So if your cervical region is involved, then the name given is cervicofacial actinomycosis. Second type is thoracic actinomycosis, in which lung is getting infected. Third variety is abdominal actinomycosis, in which ileum, cecum or appendix can be involved. And the fourth variety is pelvic type of actinomycosis. We will see each category one by one. Alright. So first category, first type of actinomycosis is cervicofacial actinomycosis. The name itself suggests here your face area is involved. It involves particularly your cervical area. And the common site of affection is this one. This is the jaw area. So it commonly affects your jaw. Alright. And this particular category is the most common form of the infection. It's a most common type. And obviously the source of infection is your normal commensal of oral cavity. It could be because of tonsil infection, dental caries, or by some trauma. Alright. And the prognosis is very good in such variety. So we can say that cervicofacial actinomycosis is having the best prognosis. Alright. Now guys, in this cervicofacial actinomycosis, initially you will have the infection in the jaw area. So you will have the swelling in that area. You will have the jaw swelling. It is known by the name lumpy jaw. Gradually, this swelling will convert it into abscess. Abscess means you will have the pus collection. You will have extensive inflammation with neutrophils. So you will develop an abscess. Gradually, this abscess can burst, and it can form the sinus to the overlying connecting skin. So over the skin, you can develop the discharging sinus. From the sinus, there can be discharge of pus, which contain the yellow sulfur granules. And gradually, even if you are not doing the treatment, then actinomycosis can damage your surrounding soft tissue of the mandible area, and mandible bone also can be damaged. So it can gradually invade your surrounding soft tissue and it can damage the underlying mandible bone. So that is the presentation of actinomycosis in cervicofacial variety. Alright. Now we will see the second category, that is thoracic actinomycosis, in which your lung is getting infected. You will have the inflammation in the lung parenchyma, that's why you will develop the pneumonia. So obviously you will have the consolidation in the x-ray, or sometime it can show the mass, and if you do the biopsy, then your diagnosis will be actinomycosis. Now in the thoracic variety, you can assume that lung is getting infected because you might aspirate the content from the oral cavity. So the source of infection is aspiration into the lung from the oral cavity, or it can develop from the extension of nearby area. Suppose you have the liver or GI tract actinomycosis, then it can extend into your lung. So that can be the source of different source of infection. And guys, this infection, if not getting treated, then it can spread to the pleura, overlying pleura, it can infect the rib, it can infect the vertebra, and finally you can develop discharging sinus as well. Alright. Third category is the abdominal actinomycosis. The name itself suggests here you will have GI tract involvement. Particularly it can infect your ileum, cecum like small intestine or appendix. And it can infect your liver as well. So these are the different site of involvement in abdominal actinomycosis. And obviously you can assume that the source of infection is swallowing of the bacteria from the oral cavity. Or you can develop abdominal actinomycosis because of extension from the nearby infected area, that is from the lung. From the lung you can develop abdominal actinomycosis because of extension of infection. So this is about the abdominal actinomycosis. Alright. Fourth category is, guys, pelvic actinomycosis, which is related to one device that is used commonly, is the intrauterine Cooper device, IUCD. It's a form of contraception. So because of IUCD use, you can develop pelvic actinomycosis. You know very well that this Cooper T, that is the intrauterine copper device, is inserted into your uterus area. So the pelvic actinomycosis will involve your uterine area. Alright. And this is the most important MCQ. Sometime in the exam, you can give them the case history of IUCD insertion. And then finally your diagnosis can be pelvic actinomycosis if pelvic inflammatory disease like clinical scenario is given. Alright. Now guys, we will see the morphology of actinomycosis. So guys, it's very easy to understand the morphology of actinomycosis. Alright. Grossly, you will have the swelling or mass. You will have some form of swelling or mass in the affected area. If you do the biopsy, guys, then this is the morphological presentation. In the histopathology, centrally you will have the pus collection. This is your center area. You have to follow the laser light to understand the morphology completely. Alright. Centrally you will have the pus collection. This is the pus, acute inflammatory cell. And you will have the bacterial colony. This is the bacterial colony. Alright. So centrally you will have the bacterial colony and the acute inflammatory cell in the form of pus. Alright, it's a heavy inflammation, heavy acute inflammatory cell infiltrate. So we can say that this is a suppurative infection. Alright, and in the bacterial colony you can see that there is a radiating blue filaments. These are the radiating filaments. So in the bacterial colony you will have the radiating filaments. And that's why initially in the past, this organism this particular infection is known as a fungal infection, but actually it is not a fungus, it is a bacteria. And within this bacterial colony you will have the sulfur granules. So this is the central portion of your affected area. Now in the periphery you will have the chronic inflammatory cell. Here you can see that this is your lymphocytes. Alright, these small dots with scanty cytoplasms are your lymphocytes. Here is your lymphocytes. Alright. And second inflammatory cell that is present is plasma cells. So you will have the lymphocytes and plasma cell. These are the plasma cell in which the nucleus is pushed to the periphery. You will have the peripherally placed nucleus in the plasma cell. So these two type of cells are present. Now guys, in this particular infection your macrophage are getting modified and you will have the activated macrophage which will form the giant cell. So here there is a presence of giant cells. You can see these multinucleated cells are the giant cell. That's the most important finding. And guys, the periphery of the rim is formed by the fibrosis. So here you will have the fibrosis. So we can say that in the morphology of actinomycosis, centrally you will have the bacterial colony which have the radiating filaments, surrounding which you will have the acute inflammatory cell, you will have the pus cells, and surrounding the central focus you will have the lymphocytes, plasma cell and the giant cells, that is the modified macrophage. And finally outer coat is formed by fibrosis. Alright, now this is the diagram of actinomycosis. This is the bacterial colony and surrounding which you will have the infective area. Here you can see somewhat club ants. These club ants are represent the secreted immunoglobulin. Hyaline eosinophilic club ant represent the secreted immunoglobulin. And this is not the fungus. Remember guys, initially because of radiation filament, it was common misconception that it is a fungal infection, but it's a bacterial infection, that is true now. Alright. Now we will see the diagnosis. So guys, for the diagnosis, first of all, you can do the immunoassay in which we will detect the antigen or antibody in the serum. You can take the swab and do the culture examination as well. In the culture, you can identify the causative organism, that is actinomycete. As well as histopathology also conclusive in diagnosis of actinomycosis. And this is the histopathological examination. In the morphology, it will look like this. Alright, this is the morphology of actinomycosis in the histopathology. Alright, fourth modality is you can do the gram stain. It's a gram positive. It's a non-acid fast bacteria. And you can sometime apply the special stain for diagnosis of actinomycosis, which is methamine silver stain, gomori methamine silver stain, that is known by the name GMS stain. Alright, so these are the different modalities for the diagnosis of actinomycosis. Alright, finally now we will see the treatment aspect of actinomycosis. So guys, as far as the treatment is concerned, you can give the two antibiotics, that is the penicillin or doxycycline. And this antibiotic has to be given for several weeks, at least for the 6 to 8 weeks. So it will take a many months to respond. The response is not dramatic like that in 1 to 2 weeks, like that of other bacterial infection. Here you have to give the time. It will take few weeks to respond. And guys, finally, sometime if mass is present, then you can surgically remove that affected area, or hyperbaric oxygen therapy also can be used. Alright, so guys, this was all about the actinomycosis. Now we will see some of the brainstorming MCQs. So first MCQ is, which of the following person is more prone for development of actinomycosis? Mental retardation, smoking, alcoholic, or none of above? So guys, here the answer will be the mental retardation, because in that condition the patient might aspirate the oral cavity content and can develop the actinomycosis infection. So it could be most appropriate answer. However, smoking and alcohol also can be the risk factor, but appropriate answer is mental retardation. Alright. Second number of MCQ is 26-year patient presented with 45 respiratory rate per minute and difficult breathing. Chest X-ray shows nodule. Discharging sinus present in the chest skin. So what's your probable diagnosis? So here history itself is a clue. When the discharging sinus is present, it could be TB or actinomycosis. Usually discharging sinus is not seen in pneumococcal pneumonia. So it could be because of actinomycosis of lung. That could be the most appropriate answer. Alright. Which drug is used for treatment of actinomycosis? So answer is penicillin and doxycycline. So both of above. Alright, this is my reference for today's lecture. Alright, so guys, thank you very much. So guys, these two particular images can be asked in the exam. So again, I am summarizing the morphology of actinomycosis in 1 minute. So in the actinomycosis histopathological examination, centrally you will have the acute inflammatory cell and bacterial colony which shows the radiating filament, surrounding which you will have the lymphocytes and plasma cell, along with the presence of modified macrophage that will form the giant cell, which is multinucleated cells, and the peripheral coat is formed by fibrosis. This is the actinomycosis infection. Alright, so guys, this is all about the actinomycosis infection. Thank you very much. If you like my video, then like, share and subscribe my channel. And if you have any query, then you can ask in the comment section. Alright guys, thank you very much, and I will try to make more and more videos of pathology. So stay tuned.